Welcome back. We'll get to Warriors title chances in a second, but first some highlights presented by Hilton. Nuggets Blazers. Dame Lillard bumped by Nikola Jokic, but somehow still gets the off-balance jumper.
Dame and CJ were excellent last night with the season on the line. They are going to they combined for 62. They're going to need to combine for at least that, if not more, if they're going to go into Denver Sunday evening and get that win.
All right, Raptors Sixers now. Tobias Harris avoiding the block, finishes the double pump dunk. He's been quiet this series.
Yeah, and again yesterday, another inefficient game from him. It didn't matter, but that's another guy. Everyone on Philly, if they're going to go into Toronto and get a Game 7 win, is going to have to play up to their averages, if not above.
Yeah, good game plan by Brett Brown, trying to get the ball in the paint early. Sixers dominated in the paint throughout the game.
Same game here. Jimmy Butler, following his miss, ends up with the N1.
Jimmy Butler had it going. You got to box out the shooter. The shooter is the greatest probability of getting the rebound because he knows where the ball's going.
Yeah, that's on Siakam. Siakam watches Jimmy Butler shooting and just turns around. Poor Kyle Lowry's trying. Watch this. Lowry's trying to box out Mike Scott. Then he's got to box out Jimmy Butler. Come on, Pascal.
Finally, Kawhi going to the hoop strong, denied by Joel Embiid, which leads to this, the Ben Simmons layup in transition.
Philadelphia, they're ever going to win championships. It's going to be a lot like this. You go to the glass, Joel Embiid swats it off. Ben Simmons in the open court where he thrives at 6'10 as a point guard. This is what it looks like, 76ers.
That is the best version of this team. Forcing misses, Simmons out in the open court.
All right, let's get back to the Warriors now. Kevin Durant's calf injury has made waves in the gambling world. Golden State's odds to win the title are now the lowest they have been all season. However, they still have slightly better odds than the Bucks, the team with the second best odds to win it all and arguably the best player currently playing in the playoffs. Nick, who has a better chance to win the title, the Warriors or the Bucks?
With respect to the good people in Las Vegas, my friends, the bookmakers out there, this one's wrong. Now, it's right in that I'm sure they're just trying to get even money, whatever it is. But the best team left, the team that right now is most likely to win the championship, is the team that employs that guy right there, Giannis. It's the team that right now goes 8 deep and is getting a starter back in Malcolm Brogdon, just got him back. It's the only team that has already advanced to the next round. It's the healthiest team in these playoffs and the team that was the best in the regular season. It's the Milwaukee Bucks. So I understand the respect to Golden State. I understand that Golden State, especially since the belief is if they can get past Houston, they still have Kevin Durant coming back by the time they get to the NBA Finals. And they probably believe if Golden State gets past Houston, they have an easier conference finals matchup against Denver or Portland than Milwaukee would have against Toronto or Philly, certainly than against Toronto. But Milwaukee's been the best team all year long. They continue to be the best team, and nothing to me that has happened this postseason changes my mind on that.
Yeah, I think this would be a great matchup, either Houston or the Warriors, but we're talking about the Warriors and the Bucks, and I could see how the Bucks would match up. And if you look at, you got to go beyond the starting five. Where Golden State, where they're hurting right now as far as their bench. And, man, Golden State, man, I believe they would have tremendous problem with Milwaukee. They just got Brogdon back. He played 16 critical minutes in that game-clenching number five that I believe will be invaluable once we get to the NBA Finals. Mirkic, he's back playing. He's played several games and even been in the starting lineup. But I believe this comes down to coaching. Win Golden State, because you know they have to go small at some point. What will the Bucks do to counteract that? And will they put Giannis at center? Because if they put Giannis at center with all the shooters they have, correct, I believe that that unit right there would give the Warriors fits. That bench and Giannis playing the center potentially, I believe, is the difference in the series.
That, to me, is the key to if this series were to happen, and it's why I don't only favor the Bucks in the East, I favor them to win the title even if they have to play Golden State. Because I don't think you can effectively play the Hamptons five against the Milwaukee Bucks. I just don't. So even when Kevin Durant gets back, Kevin Durant's been a rim protector against the Rockets. Well, Clint Capella, to steal a line from my friend Sean Pendergast, has spatula for hands, so he can't hurt him. And Harden, while he's a bulldog and he's broad shoulders and strong, he is not tall enough to really give Kevin Durant troubles when he goes in there. Giannis is almost as tall as KD. Giannis is way stronger, bless you, than Kevin Durant. And so what are you going to do? Are you going to ask Draymond Green to guard Giannis? Okay, good luck. Like, Draymond Green is a great defender. He cannot deal with Giannis because of the size disadvantage, and Draymond Green doesn't have much of a strength advantage on him. So the Warriors would have to play a center. And if you're going to play a center, then all of a sudden your offensive efficiency is going to dip dramatically. This is a series where they would miss Boogie Cousins. Where all these things matter when you are playing a team of Milwaukee's caliber. But I happen to believe, that what has happened with the Bucks is obviously people that watch these shows, they have real jobs, right? So they can't watch NBA League Pass all year long. A lot of their cues on teams come from listening to the experts, listening to the people on television.
Yes.
And I don't think a lot of people watched Milwaukee throughout the year. And I don't think a lot of people even watched Milwaukee in that first round against Detroit. It was more on the NBA TV side of things.
And Nick, give us some that. You're not trying to insult people, but there's just some things about Milwaukee.
People are shocked by it. How about this? Milwaukee is number one defense in basketball while allowing more three-pointers than any team in the league. How's that possible? Wait, what? In an era of three-point shooting, Milwaukee allows the most three-pointers of any team in basketball with the number one defense because they never foul you and they will not let you score at the rim. Brook Lopez has turned himself into an excellent defender. Eric Bledsoe always has been, and Giannis might win Defensive Player of the Year. So I think what happened was, for a lot of people, their first exposure to the Bucks all year, first time they watched an entire Bucks game was game one against Boston Celtics. And they're like, oh, see? I knew Boston was better than this in Milwaukee. How good could they really
be? This is just the Atlanta Hawks
exactly
with Coach Bud again.
100%. But that's not who they are. And people are going to be shocked when they see Giannis, who's been putting up these numbers in limited minutes. He hasn't had to play 40-plus minutes a night. The improvement of Giannis and his ability to affect every part of the game, for Milwaukee to be the second best three-point shooting team in basketball where their best player doesn't shoot threes. Think about what that means about their supporting cast. They are deep. To me, they're the favorites. I think they're going to win the title no matter who comes out of the West.
Okay, so, but at some point you have to factor in the intangibles, right? Which team is going to play better under the grand national spotlight? Which team is going to play better when you're down a couple games and you're faced with the pressure, which the Bucks really haven't been yet? Which team is going to play better when their backs are up against the wall at the end of a game or trying to go on a run? And I think if you answer all three of those questions, it's going to be the experience and the veteran players of the Golden State Warriors. And I think it may not be the dominant factor, but it has to be a factor when you're deciding who is going to be better off between these two teams.
No doubt. No doubt on the tail of the tape. When you size it up, yes, you can put, oh man, over here as far as three-point shooting, who's a better three-point shooting team? And people that have been watching basketball, they'll know Milwaukee has that advantage. Well, who's better at guarding the three-point line? People know Golden State will. Who's better at defensively protecting the rim? We know that the Milwaukee, but when you get down to intangibles, coach, experience, grit, things that how you win a championship, willing to stick together, overcoming tremendous obstacles. Kevin Durant, if he's back in the lineup, the process of, man, this is the last time us playing together, trying to three-peat. All those things, yes, they're a part of the story, but they're not the whole story because it still ultimately is about matchups. Golden State does not match up well. It would be their worst matchup in the 5 years when they've gotten to the finals, be their worst matchup, even those teams with LeBron on, because LeBron didn't have the type of support and cast that they have with Giannis.
And LeBron never had home court. It would be the first time Golden State opens up an NBA Finals on the road. It's the first time they'd be facing a Game 7 on the road in the NBA Finals.
There's this guy on Twitter who's a big Bucks fan. For some reason, of all the things that I've said, I guess the thing I've been the most consistent on, I don't even know why, is that I don't know if the Bucks will win, or I don't have that much confidence in them. So I'm sorry, guy, because now I feel bad that I once again have just gone up on the Bucks. Hey, coming up is James Harden's legacy on the line.
A dude yelled at me. at me on the street yesterday. Was like, your Raptors take sucks, Nick. Guy on the street. My bad. That's didn't next.
Didn't help my case.
On First Things First. Guy on Twitter. It's a guy.